Salutations, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new around here, welcome. My name is Nicholas Che. I'm a lifestyle content creator, but today we're doing a video that I've probably never done on this channel, but has been highly requested. But today I'm gonna show you guys my entire watch collection. As you can see, this is a pretty hefty box, but this is my jewelry organizer where I keep all my watches, accessories, and has honestly been my most prized possession. Now today we're only going to be talking about my entire watch collection. The jewelry and accessories will be a separate video. So if you haven't already, please make sure to hit that subscribe button so you guys are notified of when that video releases. But yeah, guys, I mean, watches have been something that I have been particularly into ever since I got into college. I think having a nice collection of watches is something that really signifies going into adulthood and is honestly one of the biggest factors that will help elevate your style without breaking the bank. Now, obviously, a lot of these watches have been accumulated over the past couple of years. And as a side note, as an influencer, some of these watches have been sent over to me, but no one is sponsoring today's video. But let's just go ahead and get started. And I think it's best to start off with the watch that I've been wearing the most frequently on a daily basis, and that is going to be my new Apple Watch. Now this baby is something that I got for Christmas this past year, and it's the Apple Watch SE. I've only been rocking it for a couple of weeks now, but I can definitely say that this is probably going to be one of the best investments if you're looking for a smartwatch. If you didn't know already, they came out with the SE version, which is a more affordable option, but basically has all the same features and functionalities of the Apple Watch Series 6. It's one of the best bang for buck smartwatches out there, but I've been super impressed with this. But definitely the coolest part about this watch is going to be this custom Louis Vuitton strap that I will leave in the link in the description down below. All right, now when it comes to watches, there are a couple of styles that I normally go for. I definitely want to invest in timeless pieces that will look good with any sort of outfit, and this is honestly one of my favorite ones. This one right here is from a company called The Fifth, but it's just very sleek, very modern, and I love the brown strap that it comes with. This is something that can easily be dressed up for a more sophisticated outfit, but it's also a great addition to any sort of casual outfit. I will do my best to try and leave the links to these watches in the description down below, but as I mentioned, a lot of these have been collected over the past few years. Now, a very similar style to that previous one is actually going to be our very own Caraway watch. Honestly, without even my own personal bias, I can actually say that this is probably one of the sleekest and most timeless watches in my entire collection. This is something that will never go out of style because you've got this really nice brown leather strap. The very simple white dial with the rose gold housing is something that is very understated but looks very sleek and professional. It's not super flashy and it's something that can actually be worn on a daily basis. And out of all the watches in my collection, this is definitely going to be the most affordable one. So if you guys want to pick yours up today, head to caraway.shop and this is going to be a watch that will last you for a long time. Now, this is probably one of the oldest watches in my collection, but that's going to be a Daniel Wellington. Obviously, Daniel Wellington is one of the biggest watch brands in the world right now, but this is actually something I invested in middle school or high school. And as you can tell, it's something that has lasted me several years. But the reason I was drawn to this watch in particular is that it's just something that is so timeless, so classy, and will never go out of style. It's also definitely the thinnest watch in my collection. So this is something that can easily be dressed up or down. And if you're looking for a watch that will last you a long time, I can't recommend Daniel Wellington enough. So those were the majority of my leather watches. Now let's move over to my metal ones. This baby right here is honestly pretty fire. It's from a company called Breda, and if you don't know about them, then I highly recommend checking out their website because they have tons of unique styles that you can't really find anywhere else. As soon as I saw this gold watch, I knew that it was an instant cop because it's just so flashy, so unique with the square face, and it's something that's definitely going to get you a lot of compliments. In addition to that, I particularly like to match my jewelry and accessories with the type of metal that my watch is wearing. So if I'm wearing more silver accessories like this watch or my earrings, then I will definitely be busting out this watch for movement. Obviously, I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard from Movement, but they have an incredible selection of watches for pretty affordable prices, but they definitely look very high end. I'm a huge fan of the silver Jubilee bracelet, and the navy blue dial is something that is absolutely beautiful. This one right here is definitely going to be one of the more flashy watches in my collection. So if I'm wearing a suit or definitely want to dapper up, then I will definitely be rocking this one right here. And finally, to round out my metals collection, this one is in a rose gold color from, once again, The Fifth. To be honest, this isn't a watch I rock a ton, but it's still a pretty cool one. And if I want to switch up the vibes and go for a more chunky watch, then this one does the job perfectly. All right, finally, we are going to be moving over to my holy trinity of watches. These are the top tier of my collection. These are the bad boys that I bust out only when I'm trying to flex on some people, but this one right here is a beast. It's honestly so badass. It's very sleek, very lightweight. It looks like an AP or an Audemars Piguet, like you hear all the rappers talking about. And it's just something that is so sophisticated yet understated. It's something that you can easily rock with any sort of outfit. And yeah, I get a ton of questions from you guys asking where I got this watch. So once again, it's from D1 Milano. And yeah, by far, this is definitely one of the best watches in my collection. Now moving over, this is actually a gift that I got for Christmas. I can't verify its authenticity, but it is a Hublot watch. And yeah, I mean, there's really not much you can say about it. It looks badass. It looks like a couple $100,000 watch, yet my mom got it for me for Christmas. But regardless, I do rock this every now and then because it's just got such a sophisticated, yet I don't even know how to describe it because it's a mix of like metal and leather and steel and aluminum. So it's just a freaking beautiful watch. Like, look at this bad boy. And then finally, yep. The prized possession, the crown jewel, the only watch I would keep in a watch winder box like this. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's not a stopwatch. It's a Rolex. Well, first off, if you're new to the channel, please don't think that I'm just flexing this because I have a Rolex. I rarely talk about it. And this is actually the first time I'm really showcasing it in a video.
This right here is a Rolex Statejust in the 36 millimeter with a two-tone gold and silver Jubilee bracelet. I mean, there's a whole story behind how I found this watch, why I decided to purchase it. But let me just tell you that this has honestly been one of the best investments, one of the best watches, one of the best pieces in my collection. And it's something that every time I look down at my wrist, I'm like, damn, this is a freaking beautiful, amazing piece of artwork, of craftsmanship, and honestly, it's just the peak of my adulthood. Like, buying a Rolex when I turned 21 was something that I've been always wanting to do, and it's perfect, really. As you can see, it's got this black face with diamonds encrusted on each of the numbers. And yeah, for my first luxury watch, I definitely wanted something that's pretty flashy, but at the same time, still kind of understated and is going to look great with any sort of outfit that I'm rocking. If you want to hear the whole story about why I decided to purchase this Rolex, make sure to go listen to the podcast, which will be linked in the description down below. All right, guys, I think that about wraps up my entire watch collection. If you made it this far, I just want to let you know that number one, this isn't meant to flex on any of you guys to show that I have this many watches. It's really just a testament to collecting valuable things over time and to share with you guys some of the pieces that really help elevate my style. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to drop a like down below. Comment if you guys want to see more videos talking about my fashion. And don't forget to subscribe so you guys can see what's in the rest of my jewelry box. And as always, folks, don't stress, finesse, peace.